Isaiah 11 and 10. And in that day, there shall be a root of Jesse, which shall stand for an ensign of the people. To it shall the Gentiles seek, and his rest shall be glorious. And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again the second time to recover the remnant of his people, which shall be left from Assyria, and from Egypt, and from Pathros, and from Cush, and from Elam, and from Shinar, and from Hamath, and from the islands of the sea. And he shall set up an ensign for the nations, and shall assemble the outcasts of Israel, and gather together the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth. All praises and glory goes to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, double honors to the apostles and elders of Yasharallah, and salutation to the, all of the Akim throughout the four corners of the earth, preaching the truth and sincerity, and keeping the faith of Yahweh Shai and the gospel. This is Hawa Ya'ala, just going into a brief lesson just concerning, you know, the magnification of the name of Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, all right, throughout the four corners of the earth. And this is basically just going over, you know, a brother that was out there in the Philippines that basically was, you know, commenting on some of my videos. And, you know, he believes on the name of Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai. He basically has taught it to his son as well, as you see in the image. And, you know, this is very spiritual because, you know, I was talking to the brother, you know, Zion Allah. And basically he was just talking about how he wants to see, you know, the name of Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai magnified. And he can't wait to see a so-called Asian, all right, or a so-called, you know, confusion of face Asian that's basically, you know, magnifying that name. And it just so happened about a couple of days later, you know, I seen, you know, this comment, you know, in one of my videos, all right, from a brother that's all the way out in the Philippines, all right? We're talking about pushing out the word in Tagalog, all right? And basically, he believes on the name, all right? He basically came across, you know, our videos. And as you see, this is the power of, you know, the unicorn of the internet, as, you know, Apostle Tahar has taught, all right, to all these scoffers out there that don't believe in the power, all right, of the internet being basically set up, you know, as a tool for us to reach the elect throughout the four corners of the earth, okay? And so basically, you know, he's taught his three-year-old son the name. You know, he was commenting about how his son says the name all the time and how they believe on the name and how, you know, he's getting into the word. And so, you know, we're about to be out of this place, man. This right here should be, you know, uplifting to all the Akim, showing you that there's men that are throughout the four corners of the earth, all right, all the way as far as the Philippines, okay, Southeast Asia, all right, that have believed on the name and believed on the gospel, okay? So, you know, just, again, Kahala, Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, all right, for giving us, you know, this truth that we're able to be the ones that are magnifying this name, all right? And that name of that demon, all right, Jesus Christ, all right, which is basically Cesare Borgia, all right, is being deflated, all right? It's being completely brought down low because this name is going to be magnified throughout the four corners of the earth, all right? And after it's magnified throughout the four corners of the earth, it's going to be taken throughout the universe, all right? So, you know, reading this Psalm 22:22, I will declare thy name unto my brethren. In the midst of the congregation will I praise thee, all right? And this is what this, you know, brother did. You know, he basically brought out that name, you know, in the midst of his, of the brethren, all right? In the midst of the congregation, all right? Showing that he believes on that name, all right? And didn't have, was not ashamed of that name either, all right? Was proud to say that this is the name that he believes on, all right? So this is just showing you again that the works that you have been out here, that you brothers have been doing for all these years, that it's basically, you know, bearing fruit across the four corners of the earth, you know, and starting on, you know, from down from the apostles to the elders, all right, and to the men that have continued to keep their hand to the plow and continue to push this work, all right? So all the sit downs, all right, that brothers do in their homes, all the preaching that you do out there in the streets, the Most High sealing the elect, all right, with the name, all right, which is required, okay, that they're gonna have to have the name written in their foreheads, all right? So this right here is showing you that this place is about to go down, all right? Esau's kingdom is done, all right? And if this is just one person that said that they believe on the name, how many more people believe on the name throughout the four corners of the earth, right? They maybe don't have regular access to internet, but maybe they might have seen one time the name and they believed on it, and they're out there pushing the truth, right? Most High is controlling the different men out there that are His, all right, to continue to push this truth and to seal, all right, the elect. All right, 1 Chronicles 17 and 24, let it even be established that thy name may be magnified forever, saying Yahweh of hosts is the power of Israel, even a power to Israel, and let the house of David thy servant be established before thee. All right, so the name of the Most High is going to be continually magnified, right? And it's going to be magnified forever, the name of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai. All right, and again, going into Psalm 34 and 1, I will bless Yahweh at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in Yahweh. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. All right, and who's the humble? The humble is going to be the ones that believe on the name. All right, the ones that don't look at themselves as being more than what they are. All we are is the servants of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai. All right, but other men that basically seek their own glory will not magnify this name, all right, because they're not humble, all right? And this is the reason why it's important that we continue to push this name, that we continue to say the name, and we continue to magnify it, because the brothers that are going to believe, that are of the elect, they're going to be the ones that's going to hear, and they're going to be converted, all right? And it's going to be another soul, all right, that's going to be, you know, in the kingdom, you know, Ottawa and Rochester, we're all those men as well, all right? So you're just seeing again and again that this name is being magnified, and it's being shown again and again that what the brothers have been doing, the labor every day, the late nights, all right, the prayers, all right, the fasting, all right, the getting together in camp, all right, going to meetings, all right, basically doing everything you can in this truth, all right, and you put every single last bit of yourself as you can as to whatever the measure that Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai has given you to push it out and to show that men are being sealed across the four corners of the earth, all right? And that's why the praise is continually is going to be in our mouth, all right? We make our boast in the name of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai and not our own names, okay? And then this is the prayer, you know, from Solomon. This is just a part of it. 2 Chronicles 6 and 33. Then hear thou from the heavens, even from thy dwelling place, and do according to all that the stranger calleth to thee for, that all people of the earth may know thy name and fear thee, as doth thy people Israel, and may know that this house which I have built is called by thy name. Okay? And that's the memorial, all right, that was set up from the beginning, all right? With Solomon, who came back as Yahweh Shai, the purpose was to build up that house that was going to be in the name of Yahweh Baal Shem Yahweh Shai, okay? And that's what the whole world is going to realize when this house is completed, all right? Which is basically the sealing of the elect, okay? So this is, just more edification, right, about the importance of the name being what's being the memorial, all right? The name is the memorial of Israel, okay? And again, this is just showing you the importance of the house that's being built, and this house is being built upon this name, okay? So 2nd Ezra chapter 2, starting at verse 42, and it says, I, Ezra, saw upon the Mount Zion a great people, whom I could not number, and they all praised the Lord with songs. And in the midst of them there was a young man of a high stature, taller than all the rest, and upon every one of their heads he set crowns, and was more exalted, which I marveled at greatly. And that's Yahweh Shai, basically giving the elect, all right, their reward, which is those incorruptible crowns, basically the real glory that is going to be, you know, had, all right, that's going to be had forever, all right, even forever and ever, all right? And he says, so I asked the angel and said, sir, what are these? He answered and said unto me, these be they that have put off the mortal clothing and put on the immortal and have confessed the name of the Most High. Now are they crowned and receive palms. right? So that immortal clothing is talking about these vile bodies and putting on that that glorious tabernacle, all right? That's going to be fashioned after the body of Yahweh Shai, all right? So it's going to be basically us turning from the state that we're in these chains of darkness, which is our bodies, all right, which basically leads to death, and basically being put into something that's going to be completely incorruptible, all right, and that's going to basically allow us to live forever. And said, then said I unto the angel, what young person is it that crowneth them and giveth them palms in their hands? And he answered and said unto me, it is the Son of the Most High, whom they have confessed in the world. All right, and that's the key. That's part of this lesson, is that this is a man that's all the way out in the Philippines, and he has confessed in the world. All right, he's confessed in the world, not only to the oikumene, all right, which is basically the inhabited earth, by basically confessing that comment, but he's also confessed it to the world of Israel, of Yahshua, that this is the name to believe on, Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. Okay, then began I greatly to commend them that stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord. All right, so all the works that we're doing, standing up for this name, being ridiculed for the name, all right, because the name is being completely looked down upon by our nation, all right, and this is the reason why we continually must fight for this name, all right, because this is what is written here in the scriptures, all right, that there was men, all right, that stood stiffly, all right, for the name, and Ezra's commended those men, all right, seeing that he's also among those men in the future, all right, that is going to stand for that name in the last days, all right. Then the angel said unto me, go thy way and tell my people what manner of things and how great wonders the Lord thy power thou hast seen. Okay? So this is just another one of the great wonders, all right, that we've seen Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai do, which is basically seal a man all the way in the Philippines, all right, and he believed of the name of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. All right? So again, all praises and glory goes to Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, and double honors to the apostles and elders of Yahshua, and salutation to the Akim throughout the four corners of the earth, preaching his truth in sincerity and keeping the faith of Yahweh Shai in the gospel. Shalom.